today's live session, 7:30 p.m., we'll focus on a specific topic. So as you can see, sterilization and disinfection of various materials which we come across in our daily clinical practice or maybe in our college. So we'll have an interactive kind of session where I'll give you the examples or I'll quote the materials and you let me know through which method they are sterilized or maybe they are disinfected, right? So we'll proceed that way. So once again, a very good evening, all of you. Hi, Sridevi, Mubashira, Ajaj, Bernice. Hi, Danish. Hi, Samya. A very good evening. Hi, Shyam. You can drop a mail at proptobeidentist@gmail.com. This session will confine to subject discussion. Fine? Yes. Okay, it's never too late. Fine, Danish, it's never too late. So first we'll start with materials. I'll write materials on one side and you let me know which method is used for sterilizing those materials. Fine? And let me know inoculating wires or inoculating loops which we use for specimen preparation in microbiology. So how are these sterilized? Inoculating wires or inoculating loops? Yes. So we have different sterilization methods, right? Dry heat based on moist heat, and then we have chemical sterilization also. We use different materials depending upon the properties. We have different methods. Yes. Yeah. Flaming. Yes, direct heat in the form of flame. As you rightly said, inoculating wires or loops are sterilized by direct heat, usually through flaming method. And this comes under dry heat sterilization, isn't it? Yes, good. Now, coming to various glassware, petri dishes. So how do you sterilize them? Glassware, including syringes, petri dishes, test tubes, which are made of glass, test tubes, and oily fluids. Glassware, including oily fluids. Yes, we don't use autoclave, we use hot air oven. Good. What about culture media? In fact, we had several questions from the same in previous entrances also. Oily fluids like paraffin or glassware are best sterilized by hot air oven. What about culture media? How do you sterilize culture medium? Yes, autoclaving, culture media is sterilized through autoclaving. What about culture media containing serum, sugar or egg? The same culture media with serum, sugar or egg? How do you sterilize such a medium? Do we go for autoclaving or do we have any other procedure? Hi Radu, very good evening. So how is culture media containing serum, sugar or egg sterilized? Have you heard of a process called tindalization? So tindalization is used for sterilizing culture media containing serum, egg or sugar. Why do we go for tindalization? Why not autoclaving? And what is tindalization? So why do we go for tindalization for sterilizing culture media with serum, sugar or egg rather than autoclaving? So what could be the reason? And second, what is tindalization? Has it got something to do with the protein content? So tindalization is a procedure where we heat a substance almost till the boiling point or just below the boiling point for 3 consecutive days. And this tindalization is used for sterilization and it's also used for eliminating spores. This is very, very important, heat resistant spores. So what we do is, as I said, we do heat a substance for up to 100 degrees or close to boiling point. And then we hold it there for 15 minutes. And this procedure is repeated for 3 consecutive days. The logic behind this procedure is, after heating on the first day, during the rest period, till the next day, the spores which have survived the heating would germinate and produce or form bacteria or bacterial colonies. And these bacterial colonies are subsequently killed in the next stages of heating. So that's how this procedure actually works, tindalization. And this is used for sterilizing cultural media with serum, sugar or egg. And moreover, the serum, sugar or egg, they will be destroyed in autoclaving where we use comparatively higher temperature. As I said, in case of tindalization, it will be close to boiling point. But in autoclaving, it will be, as you know, 121 or 131 degrees centigrade depending upon the cycle which we are using. Exactly, Shridevi. Good. So that's regarding tindalization. Now, how would you sterilize disposable syringes and other disposable items? Disposable syringes or other disposable items. Hi Ram, a very good evening. Yes, Bernice, you say alpha is? Yeah. Disposable items, we don't go for autoclave sterilization. Yes, we go for gamma radiation. Gamma radiation is used. Good. Now what about various toxins, antibiotic solutions? Toxins, various antibiotic solutions, and serum, sugar, etc. So how do you sterilize these solutions? So how do you sterilize these solutions? toxins or antibiotic solutions, serum, sugars, etc. Have you heard of a process called filtration? Can filtration be used for sterilization? We go for filtration of these solutions. What about milk? How is milk sterilized? This you must be answering. How do you sterilize milk? Okay, hi Kriti. Yes. Pasteurization. Okay. What about cytoscope? Endoscope. How do you sterilize? Either a cytoscope or an endoscope. How do you sterilize a cytoscope or endoscope? Yes, it is pasteurization for milk. What about endoscope? Yes, good Radu. So what is Cydex chemical? So what is Cydex chemical? 2% butyraldehyde. And how do you sterilize an operating theater or operation theater? Sterilization of operation theater. UV rays. Formaldehyde gas. If you observe, you will have a small device with a fan which distributes this formaldehyde gas. We even have UV cabinets wherein we can sterilize instruments. You might have seen in a private setup or maybe in your college. You'll have UV cabinets where you have several racks and you can place your instruments there. It can be used for sterilization. But for operation theater, it will be formaldehyde gas. Yeah, through fumigation. What about the commonly used aprons, gloves, catheters, or your hand instruments in your respective departments? Aprons, gloves, and hand instruments. How do you sterilize them? Aprons, gloves, and have instruments. We go for auto clearing, right? However, if you use sharp instruments, there can be dulling of a sharp instruments, right? So care has to be taken and not to use sharp instruments or not to submit them for autoclaving. So how do you sterilize sharp instruments? We have a chemical method to sterilize sharp instruments. So which chemical do we use for sterilizing sharp instruments? Five percent Crisol is used for sterilizing sharp instruments. How do you disinfect skin? Is it appropriate if I say sterilizing skin? Which term is more appropriate, sterilizing skin or disinfecting skin? Yes, Reet, disinfecting you mean to say is more appropriate. Good. Mubashira, right. So you obviously know the difference between sterilization and disinfection. So what is the main difference between sterilization and disinfection in terms of materials used? Yes, disinfecting is more appropriate. Yes, so what is the major difference between sterilization and disinfection in terms of the materials which we are using? And which materials do we use for disinfecting skin? Yes, there is antiseptics, alcohol, for example, spirit, or savlon, or even tincture iodine, right? So these can be used for disinfecting. Yes, disinfection is, even betadine solution, iodine, povidone iodine. So disinfection is wherein we apply for living substances. But for inanimate objects, non-living, we go for sterilization, right? That's the basic difference, as you know. And finally, how do you treat infective material like soiled dressings, animal carcasses or bedding, infected materials? It can be your other scrap material which is infectious. How do you treat infectious or infective material like soiled dressings, beddings, or animal carcasses? Yes, Rohit. The same will be covered even in biomedical waste management. So how do you treat infected material? So I'll leave this unanswered. Yes. Akriti says incineration. Yes, Radu. Good. So these are some of the materials which we come across in our daily practice, and most importantly, from the entrance point of view, we previously had several questions on the same. So make a list of all these materials and memorize them, and also try to correlate what you're doing clinically. It will be easy for you to remember. So to summarize all that we have discussed so far, so various inoculating vials and loops can be subjected to dry heat sterilization using flaming technique or red heat. Glass wires, various petri dishes, test tubes, various glassware, and oily fluids like paraffin are subjected to dry heat, hot air oven. This is very, very important. And culture medium, without any additives, can be subjected to autoclaving. But you have additives like serum, sugar, or egg. Since they are proteins and they can be denatured or destroyed by the higher temperatures, we go for tinylization. I discussed what tinylization is. And mainly tinylization can also be used for destroying spores. This is very important, make a note of it. And various disposable materials or syringes can be subjected to gamma radiation. And toxins or any solutions, antibiotic solutions, serum, sugar, can be subjected to filtration, which is a sterilization method. And milk, as you know, pasteurization. Various instruments that are used repeatedly, cytoscope, can be subjected to chemical sterilization. Cytex is a trade name. It is nothing but 2% butyraldehyde chemically. And then you have operation theaters, which can be subjected to fumigation using formaldehyde gas. The ones which we use routinely, aprons, gloves, various hand instruments, except sharp instruments, can be subjected to autoclaving, whereas sharp instruments can be subjected to chemical sterilization using 5% Crisol. And skin can be disinfected using various disinfecting agents like 70% ethanol, tincture, iodine, various antiseptics, as you mentioned, that is iodine, betadine, or even Savlon, Dettol. Right, we have many other agents. And finally, infected material has to be subjected to incineration finally, which comes under biomedical waste management, right? So these are some of the materials, various sterilization and disinfecting procedures which can be performed depending upon the nature of material and the properties of materials, right? So this is very important. I give you importance to you during your revision. And we'll conclude here, and then at 9:30 p.m. again we'll have our MCQs discussion as usual, along with one general knowledge question. Fine? Okay then. It's almost 25 minutes. Okay, we'll conclude the session and see you again at 9:30 p.m. Right? So in the meantime, make sure you go through those multiple choice questions. And if you are a registered student, go through surprise test number 20. Complete the test as soon as possible and try attending the session. And those who are not registered, you can check out Google group where you will have a set of 5 multiple choice questions. Download the soft copy, try solving it by yourself, and then attend the session. It will be much more easier for you to follow. Fine? Yeah. See you again at 9:30. Love you. Bye.